Greetings, fellow citizens. Day 6 of the Expo. Today is HS Day, and I have to admit I find most HS ships quite nice to look at. But I like all manufacturers. And we have the Gladios. This was my second ship in Star Citizen, and then I sold her because back in the days she only had 3 size 2 gun mounts, but a long while ago she was upgunned to 3 size 3 gun mounts. I think she is a very nice ship. I like her a lot. I will again start at the right side and then go to center and left side. We have the Vanguards. Very nice ships. I like the Warden a lot. This is a Sentinel, and the gun is strange. Strangely oriented. The Warden, Harbinger, and yeah, Harbinger, Warden, and Hoplite. Yeah, I like the Warden series a lot. However, in 3.5 CRG made the cockpit view a lot worse. You have now this stupid bar right in your face that doesn't do anything for you. Please, Chris, take it back. And the problem with the Wardens is those guns at the nose. Those are 4 size 2 guns, but they cannot be gimbaled, so you cannot take advantage of auto-aim gimbals with those size 2 guns. Something ZHE will hopefully address, because gimbal assist is such an important thing. Then we have the Reclaimer. This thing is really massive. Like a lot of other ships, she has problems with shield holes, but I like this ship a lot. And I think for the most part the internal layout makes sense in the Reclaimer, unlike in the Starfarer. Yeah. I hope that we get salvaging into the game next year. Wow, this thing is really massive. I haven't flown mine for a while. And there are always problems with the elevators. Patch X, elevators work. Patch X plus 1, elevators don't work. Patch X plus 2, elevators work again. And right now the elevators don't work. So it's really, really hard to use. Then we have the Saber. Saber Standard and Saber Comet. This was my first love in Star Citizen. I remember back the day when CHE introduced the Subscribership of the Month. And the ship of the month was the Saber. So I subscribed, I got a Saber, I used her, I flew around with her, I did some missions, and after an hour I locked off, and I never locked on for the rest of the month. Why? Because the Saber was such a nice ship. She was so good. Much better than anything else I had, and I just didn't want to play this game anymore without the Saber. However, CHE not only introduced the Subscribership of the Month, they also gave us the option to buy the ship at the end of the month. So I did this. She has a very bad shield hole at the cockpit. You can kill her very, very easily. I made some videos about this. Maybe I link in the top right corner. So I hope that the shield holes will get fixed one fine day. And another thing, this is supposed to be a stealth fighter. But look at this. Fan blades. The first thing everyone learns who is designing stealth ships or stealth airplanes is, do not have visible fan blades. That's the worst thing you could do on a stealth ship. Very, very bad. But as always, Chris doesn't care about physics or engineering. He loves Rule of Cool. Well, I guess we have to live with it. Let's go to the second floor. Yeah, HS has two floors. But let me guess, no E-twisters here. Oh, that's terrible. We have the Eclipse, our stealth torpedo bomber with a lot of problems. She has three size 9 torpedoes, but there is a very significant delay between the shots. This could be much faster. She is very, very fragile. And she has a very bad cockpit view. Now, stealth doesn't require a bad cockpit view. Not in real life and not in this game. Look at the Saber. But for whatever reason, Chris likes to give the Eclipse a very, very bad cockpit view. Actually, it's worse than the cockpit view of a Starfarer, which is really, really terrible. Yeah, another problem is we still don't have hull stealth, we only have component stealth. So I hope that one fine day we will get hull stealth, and one fine day she will be able to fire her size 9 torpedoes much more quickly. And then she can be a useful ship. Right now she is just a very expensive way to spend $300 for not getting much in return. And we have the Penguins. I love the Penguins. Avenger, Avenger Titan and Avenger Warlock. And Stalker, I guess. I love the ship so much. Very useful ship for not much money. Like many other ships, she has shield holes too, but it's not too bad actually. My first ship was a Stalker. Well, back in the days wasn't a game package with a Titan, so I got a Stalker. Yeah, I like the Penguins a lot. And we have the Hammerhead. A ship that relies on turret gameplay, while turret gameplay is still, sorry, absolutely shitty. So, until turret gameplay actually improves, this ship isn't really useful. You are paying a lot of money for a ship that's, yeah, not useful. Another problem is this ship, the Hammerhead, is supposed to protect convoys against small fighters, but there are no tools whatsoever for the captain to get any tactical awareness. Things like, where am I? Where are the ships I have to protect? And where are the attackers? Nothing. All the captain has is a 2D radar screen and he can look out of the window. Good luck, this is really, really, really terrible. I hope that both things will get addressed. I hope the captain gets some tools to get situational awareness, and I hope that turret gameplay will improve. CHE could give turrets auto-aim gimbals, for example. It's very hard to hit small and agile fighters with turrets still. And we have the Retaliator. I like the look of her. She has 6 size 9 torpedoes, but like many other ships, she has a few problems. The turret layout is very bad with a lot of blind spots. The internal layout is very bad. I guess it will be almost impossible for the guys in the turrets at the back to get to the escape pods. And the MFD layout in the cockpit is very bad. And another ship with engines that wouldn't work in a spaceship, because they are way off alignment. In space, engines have to be aligned so that the vector of thrust is aligned with the center of mass. Airplanes can get away with a less than perfect alignment, spaceships not. And this thing wouldn't work in space, like a lot of other ships in Star Citizen. Yeah, no E-twisters here. I almost thought so. Very bad. I think CHE should have shown us the E-twist. We saw her last year. Well, this was Day 6. of the Expo HSD. I hope you had fun watching this and see you tomorrow. Bye. Auf Wiedersehen.
You handle this. I'm security station deck 9.
Aye, sir.
Sensors are configured.
Ah, come on. Okay.